This diagram shows how C4D works. Here we have the walls of our capillary or tubing, our sample inside. This is a transmitter electrode which applies a high frequency electromagnetic signal. This is passed onto the sample, and further along the tube or capillary, a receiver electrode picks up that signal. The eDAQ C4D lets the user select the amplitude and the frequency of the sine wave. Using the optimum amplitude and frequency is important to get the best sensitivity from the C4D detector. In PowerChrome software, for example, the excitation amplitude can be selected here, the excitation frequency here, and the headstage gain just here. The C4D profiler should be used whenever the user uses a new background electrolyte or buffer, changes the concentration of the background electrolyte or buffer, uses a capillary or tubing with different dimensions, for example, a different inner diameter or outer diameter, or when a new C4D headstage is used. You should download the software from the eDAQ website in support, software downloads. It's here. The C4D Profiler software works with all of the C4D units and all of the headstages and platforms. When you have installed the C4D Profiler software, you should connect the C4D headstage to the C4D hardware and connect it to the computer. When you turn on the C4D hardware and open the C4D Profiler, you should see something like this. You have to run the C4D Profiler with your background electrolyte in the capillary, and you can monitor that by going to Tools, Monitor Window, and setting up the settings for the maximum settings. So the headstage gain on, a frequency of about 1200 kHz, 100% amplitude. You can click Apply and Run. And we can now inject our background electrolyte into the capillary. So there you can see it's injected. And we can now click stop and close. We're now ready to set up our settings for the C4D profiler. So for the headstage gain, we're going to run with both the headstage gain on and off. For the amplitude, we're going to start at 10%, go up to 100% with 10% steps. For the frequency, we're going to start at 100 kHz, go up to 1260 kHz in 10 steps. You can now click the green arrow to start, and it's going to zero the signal. When it's finished zeroing, it's going to start the profiles. So it's starting with 10% amplitude with the headstage gain off. And it's going to try every frequency between 100 kHz and 1260 kHz and give the response. This may take a while to do. When the profile is finished, you should get a profile which looks a bit like this. If you have a more conductive background electrolyte, it might go up into this area where the detector is overloaded. You can see it's tried every amplitude with the headstage gain off and then on for every frequency, and it's giving the response here. You should ignore any C4D settings that give a value higher than 2.5. So for example, these points here should be ignored. You could, for example, decide to use these settings here. It's where the amplitude was 100%, the headstage gain was on, and a frequency of about 800 kHz was used. You could also get a better idea of the optimum settings by diluting your background electrolyte by about 10%. So that's 90% background electrolyte, 10% deionized water, putting that into the capillary and seeing the difference. We're going to do this now, and we're going to use the monitor window to inject the diluted background electrolyte. So I'm going to choose the maximum settings again. Now I'm going to inject my diluted background electrolyte. So there it is. Click stop and close. And now we're ready to do a second run. So click the green arrow. Now it's going to do a new second profile with the diluted background electrolyte. When it's finished, you should see a very similar profile to the first one. If we go down here, we can change between the first scan and the second scan. And you can see in the second scan, which is the diluted background electrolyte, the points are slightly lower response. We should now go to the scan list. We can enter the serial number of the C4D headstage in here. And we can keep notes down here. So this is the background electrolyte was scan number one. Number two, this was the diluted background electrolyte. Now we need to take the diluted background electrolyte, so that's scan number two, and we're going to set this as the base. If we now go to number one, we can subtract the base from our background electrolyte, and this is what we get. What we're getting is a difference between the background electrolyte and the diluted background electrolyte. And what we're looking for is the highest point, the highest difference between those two. But we're not going to pick the C4D settings that overloaded the detector. If we remove the base subtraction, we could see that 100% headstage gain on. At 800 kHz, the signal was below 2.5, so that's good. But this one here, 1000 kHz, the response is above 2.5, and here as well. So we're going to ignore these two points, but look at this one, it could be promising. I'm going to subtract the base again. And here we see that this could be a good C4D setting to use. So that's the amplitude 100%, the headstage gain on at about 800 kHz. You can learn more about the C4D Profiler software from its manual, which you can download from the eDAQ website. The operations section lists a procedure, as well as some advice about how to choose the best C4D settings from your profiles.